Well, hi everyone. I just want to give you a little progress report today on how my giant pumpkin plant is doing. It's doing fabulous, growing like crazy, even getting some pumpkins on it finally. So I just wanted to show you that, and I also wanted to show you how I've been taking care of it and do something tonight that will hopefully help it grow even bigger. So let's go over and take a look. Well, look at this plant. It's actually three pumpkin plants, and I cannot believe in the months since I did my last progress report how big and humongous these things have gotten. I'm just like astounded at how they've grown. I don't know how I'm gonna have enough space here in my backyard. This is crazy, absolutely crazy. And I'm just pouring the water on every day and they are just growing like mad. Now, the problem is, like I said, I'm running out of space. I actually have three plants here and I really need to take one of the plants out. So what I've decided to do is take out this middle plant here in hopes that that will provide space for these two plants on the end to spread out. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and then I'm gonna come back and show you what I have growing underneath these leaves, okay? So we'll be right back. But all the vines are connected, so I gotta do it very carefully. Tough part. Oh wow, these vines are all intertwined. I'm gonna have to go around the front and get all those leaves on the front. I hope they're not, they're all connected with this other plant. I don't know how I'm gonna get them all out. Give it a try. Can't even get over this plant, it's so big. Actually, I think this is one of them. Yep, that's what I'm gonna have to do. I can't even tell what's what in here. So what I did is I cut the main vine to the third plant that I'm taking out, but I can't tell what leaves are connected to that one and what leaves are connected to the other two plants. So what I'm gonna do is just wait a couple days for the vines I cut to shrivel up, and that way I can tell, so I'm not cutting one of the vines that I really wanna keep. So it's not gonna be too thinned out tonight, but in a couple of days, I'll be able to thin it out even better. Okay, so plan B. All right, so let me show you actually how I've been taking care of this plant. As you can see, it's not very easy to access. I do have my drip irrigation system connected in here, but I've been giving it some supplemental fertilizer, and what I've been doing, very simple, just pretty much been watering each plant with my watering can full of compost tea each day. So this is about a gallon and a half. So I've been doing that. So let me go around the back and I'll just show you, if I can get back there, I'll show you what I've been doing, okay? So hold on a second while I climb over these big, huge vines. And I know they're even gonna get huger. Okay. So what I do, what I've been doing is just at the base of each plant, except for this third plant here, I haven't been watering that. I've just been pouring my compost tea right at the base, and that gives them like an extra gallon and a half of water a day. Now the soil has not been holding water very well. If I did this again, I would definitely do it differently. I pretty much fill this with compost, and it's just not holding the water as well as I had hoped. So next year when I plant this bed out, I will definitely put in some soil that will hold, I'll mix it in with the compost, some other types of soil that will hold the water better. So I've just noticed they've been getting dried out really, really easily. So I've just been watering these every day with that. And let me show you what I've got underneath the leaves. Okay, I'm really excited about this. So let me come around front again. Okay, so let me show you what I've got here under the leaves. Now, it might not look much to some of you, because I know some of you have humongous pumpkins already, but I'm really excited about it. So let's bring you in close here and show you what I got. Here it is, folks. My giant pumpkin. Soon to be more giant, I hope. Now I have lots of other smaller pumpkins on the vine, but this one is the biggest one I have so far. So I am really gonna focus on this one. Now we're having a problem in the garden, and that problem is rats. So I'm very concerned. They already hollowed out one of my watermelon. I was so upset. We've set some traps, I have caught one, but I'm very concerned that they're gonna get my pumpkin. So what we've done as well is we have set a rat trap down here right next to the giant pumpkin. So if any rat even thinks about getting close to the pumpkin, his head's going to get snapped off. Okay, I know that might sound mean, but I don't want rats in my garden. I don't want them eating my food. Okay, that's just the way it goes. Okay, so I am really happy with the progress of my giant pumpkin. I'm actually going to try and train the vines to go over this way so it doesn't take over my whole entire yard. And we'll see how it goes. So another month or so, I'll let you know how things are going, and hopefully we can keep those rats out. So thanks a lot for watching. If you have any great tips for me, I would love to hear them. Thank you so much for all your comments already. So we'll see you on the next video. See you later.